And so to kind of touch on something that you mentioned earlier, you talked about how some of the things that you thought were common sense or commonplace were things that other guys you talked to didn't know. And you had learned those things from your father. Could you kind of dive into some of those things? What were some of those differences that you saw between what you learned from your father and your grandfather and what you see a lot of guys missing today that you might have talked to, like some of your clients?
Sure. A lot of it comes down to the idea of masculinity and what that really means. So both my grandfather and my father were masculine men. So they kind of ran the household, not that they were dictators or anything, respected women, respected their wives and considered their wives as equal partners, but they took leadership. And that's something that a lot of guys are afraid to do these days because they're kind of afraid, you know, am I supposed to be the leader of my household? Am I not? But then they also taught me, so my dad in particular taught me that it was okay to be emotional because my dad was a very big guy. He was very strong, physically had this amazing presence, but he was the most emotional man I knew. He could sit down and cry in front of you and you wouldn't think any less of him because he just still had a masculine presence. My grandfather taught me the world of spirituality and values and principles. So my great grandfather was a spiritual teacher in India for 50 years. So I got to see these elements of life that I don't think were taught to a lot of boys, and which was things like working on ourselves first, right? And in our cultural background, we have these two things, which is called seva and simran. Seva means to give, basically selfless giving, right? To give and contribute to other people and help them without expecting anything in return. And the second one is simran, which is to look from within, which means that everything that we want or need in life and feel good about is actually from within. And so I've seen a lot of my colleagues, I saw a lot of my friends, I saw them grow up to be extremely successful financially, business-wise, or career-wise, but they still weren't happy with themselves. And that was the opposite approach that I took, was really to focus on myself. And I've been doing that for a very long, long time. And at the beginning, I may not have had the wealth or the, you could say, the advancement that a lot of my friends had, but or people that I knew, but I was able to far accelerate after, because once you realize how to be complete from within, once you realize how to manage your inner state, whether there's thoughts, your emotions, or your spiritual being, it becomes infinitely powerful. You become powerful and you're able to accomplish that, those things that you want, and have that amazing career, have that amazing business. And regardless of whether you have it or not, you still feel good about yourself. So those are the approaches that I took differently that I learned at a younger age.
So just to make sure I'm understanding correctly, what you're saying is that the foundation that you got from your father was something to help you to be able to build a strong identity, so that when you went into different challenges in the future, like building your business and other things, your sense of self-worth wasn't necessarily based on the results that you're getting. You already had like a strong sense of self-worth from the identity that you had established, and you're able to go into those situations with that inner confidence to be able to succeed. Is that kind of what you're getting at?
Yeah, identity is definitely one element of it. Your belief system, for example, values and principles, these are all things that we operate by, but we don't really take a look at it. And we don't really write them down. We don't really identify them and work on them and evolve them. So these, yes, so long story short, these are all elements that were implemented at an early age, which really helped me excel.
Okay. And I know you also talked about values. What would you say were some of the challenges that you faced whenever you got into situations where the circumstances might have made it to where it was hard for you to stick to your values? Maybe the people that you're working with didn't share the same ones, and it kind of put you in a tough spot. Could you kind of describe those experiences that you might have faced?
Sure. I can tell you one of the biggest challenges that I've had early on when I was younger was just conflicting values, because I always had this thought that I wanted to be extremely wealthy. But I would always, even in business ventures, I would just give away stuff. And that doesn't really go well when it comes to business, right? Right. And so I would sit there and I'd wonder, what the heck am I going on? I'm making all this money and I'm not accumulating the wealth. So what's up? What's actually happening? When I actually sat down and identified my values, and I knew the stuff, I had just overlooked it. Money and wealth wasn't even on my values list. It wasn't even something that I truly valued. A contribution was bigger on there. And so I was conflicted, because I'm like, I want to be wealthy, but I'm not acting like I towards wealth. And so I had to identify that, to purposely actually write down wealth as one of my values, one of my core values. And then I started to make decisions differently. because that's how ultimately that's how your decisions work. That's how your performance and your progress works, is you base them on decisions that you make. And those decisions are based on your values. And if you don't have the right values, and I don't mean right or wrong, I just mean values that align with where you really want to be. If you don't have those, you're going to be challenged. And a lot of people are challenged. That, or maybe those similar to my situation, some of those values are conflicting. Because if you have conflicting values, let's just say a common one is family and wealth. And I see this all the time, because a lot of guys are torn between spending time with their family or spending time in their business. So that's a conflicting value system. And so we have to identify, well, maybe value or family needs to be higher up on the list, and maybe business and wealth has to come down. Or maybe for temporary purposes, maybe for 12 months or 2 years or 5 years, however long it is, wealth has to be at the top. And you don't have to feel guilty for not being at home all the time. And then you can change your values. The great thing about values is that you can also always change them and modify them based on where you want to be in your life.